Congressman Paul Gosar, a Republican from Arizona, thought it was a great idea to put up a violent social media post depicting him killing Representative Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez and attacking Joe Biden for good measure. Democrats, I think, obviously said, especially in the aftermath of January 6th, that this was beyond the pale. Last night, Gosar was censured and booted from his committees. What Republicans did, even by the pathetic standards of today, was beyond pathetic. Republicans after Republican, led by Mitch McConnell, they trotted out false equivalents, minimized violence. They even defended Gosar. As for Gosar, he, of course, did not apologize. In fact, he gave some cockamamie rationale about doing what he did as a way to reach the kids. Worse yet, McCarthy said, if you hold Gosar accountable, just wait if he ends up getting the gavel. He'll also decide to give time to lunatics like Lauren Boebert. When she got there, she spewed venom. She, of course, a huge defender of the insurrectionists. She's an anti-vaxxer and a lawmaker who will not even recognize Joe Biden as a legitimate president. She will, however, support stripping other Republicans from committees. Why, you ask? If they committed the unpardonable sin of supporting infrastructure. McCarthy, he learned no lessons from the last two elections. Trump, he cost Republicans Congress as well as the presidency, and as Virginia proved, you can win as a Republican if you keep Trump at arm's length. But more importantly, McCarthy took another step to yet an even more dangerous America by defending the fringe and empowering an element who thought that attacking the Capitol was reasonable and what their president's party actually stands for in 2021. What a shameful day for democracy.